We're off to outer space. We're leaving Mother Earth to save the human race. Our Star Blazers.
Okay, I understand that you have quite a few characters that you need to introduce, but the large title cards on the bottom of the screen were a little bit obnoxious. Yeah, maybe they did that in the original Yamato broadcast, but even having that appear under characters that we've already been introduced to in previous episodes just doesn't make a whole lot of sense. And it also just seems kind of unnecessary to have the title cards if you already have the characters introducing themselves in the dialogue. As for the episode as a whole, a good chunk of it can be summarized as a jazzy tour of the Argo. I'm not saying you can't have lighter music in your sci-fi series, but the bouncy, jazzy music just felt out of place from the rest of the score. Outside of that, this is a pretty straightforward episode. The Gamelons see their huge battleship destroyed by Earth's battleship, and then they decide to launch a huge missile to destroy said battleship, with the missile making its way to Earth right as the Argo is getting ready to launch on its journey to Iskandar. The only real major thing I can really comment on is one of the more subtler moments of the episode, and this occurs when you have the Star Force kind of marching down the promenade on their way to board the Argo, where you see one of the members of the crowd saying, "Hey, who's going to take care of your families when you're gone?" And then you have the other people saying, "Hey, I don't see you doing anything." Now, it's a very subtle, very easy to miss sort of thing, but it kind of gives you an idea of not everybody has faith in this mission. Not everybody thinks that this is a good idea. And again, there's not too much done with the concept, but given that that little thing is there, it's a bit of a nice touch. We also get some pretty decent character moments as we have Wildstar talking with Orion to kind of get some idea of what kind of person Captain Avatar is. And this also gives us some insight into the various struggles Captain Avatar has had to put up with over the course of the war with the Gamelons. And I also like the fact that the very first thing Orion sells to Wildstar saying, "Hey, you're not the only one who's lost family members in this war, so get over yourself." And I actually kind of like that because oftentimes in some newer anime series, you have a character that loses a loved one, and then they like stay completely like grieving and stuff for a while, and somehow the other characters aren't able to understand it. So it's nice to actually have a series where you have someone acting as a voice of reason, and actually basically not literally smacks them around, but actually effectively says, "Hey, this type of stuff happens in war. You're not the only one who's lost anyone, so don't hold a grudge." Although the voyage has officially begun now, I don't really feel like anything happened in this episode. I mean, yeah, stuff happened. They destroyed the Ultra-Menace Missile, and the Argo was launched now. But this episode just felt like one of those episodes that's meant to get you from point A to point B. Kind of like a middle scene in a movie that's just meant to move the story along without calling a lot of attention to itself. That's what this episode felt like to me. But that's all I really have to say about episode 3. There are only 23 episodes left.